Hi, welcome to Programming with Mesh. In this video, we will review the new features of the new version of React Native 0.65. This version comes with a new version of Hermes, improvements to accessibility, package upgrades, and more that make it an exciting update worth talking about. Hermes 0.8. Hermes, Facebook's open-source JavaScript VM, optimized for React Native, has been upgraded to version 0.8.1. Hermes, released in 2019, is a JavaScript engine designed to optimize React Native performance on Android devices. Hermes optimizes React Native performance on Android devices by reducing time to interaction, download size, smaller EPK file, memory utilization, garbage collector strategy. Some of the standout features in this release are a new concurrent garbage collector titled Hades, which delivers up to 30 times shorter pause times on 64-bit devices. According to the Facebook experience, this improves some CPU-intensive workloads by 20% to 50%. Hades is a garbage collector for Hermes that aims to improve pause times by an order of magnitude over GenGC. The main principle Hades uses to achieve those low pause times is that most of the garbage collection work happens in a background thread concurrently with the interpreter running JavaScript code. ECMAScript Internationalization API is now built into Hermes on Android and enabled by default with only 57 to 62 kilobyte per API size overhead compared to JSC's 6 megabyte. With this change, Hermes users no longer require local polyfills. This is still evolving, and the latest iteration is 7th edition, which was published in June 2020. Hermes on iOS now supports Apple M1 Max and Mac Catalyst. This is a welcomed update for all M1 users out there. If support for the M1 has been holding you back from taking the plunge, now might be a good time to start your React Native journey. Mac Catalyst allows you to bring your existing iOS app to macOS, taking advantage of the max screen size, keyboard, and faster speed. The update coincides with the upcoming release of macOS Monterey. This is great news if you're an iPad app developer, turning your iPad app into a Mac app, because you can now bring the power of Hermes with you. Memory improvements including SMI, small integers, and pointer compression that shrank JS heap by 30%. Changes to function.prototype.toString that fix the performance drop due to improper feature detection and supports the source code injecting use case. Accessibility fixes and additions. Last year, Facebook took the GAAD pledge, Global Accessibility Awareness Day, to improve accessibility within React Native. 0.65 shares the results of this pledge and other accessibility wins. Some notable changes include: allow a specification of high contrast, light and dark values for iOS. The dynamic color iOS function is a platform color type specific to iOS. Dynamic color iOS takes a single argument as an object with two mandatory keys, dark and light, and two optional keys, high contrast light and high contrast dark. These correspond to the colors you want to use for light mode and dark mode on iOS, and when high contrast accessibility mode is enabled, high contrast version of them. At runtime, the system will choose which of the colors to display, depending on the current system appearance and accessibility settings. Dynamic colors are useful for branding colors or other app-specific colors that still respond automatically to system setting changes. This is an example of changing the app color by changing the device theme applied to a new project. Added Get Recommended Timeout Millis API on Android. This exposes a user's preferred default timeout value as set in Android's accessibility options and is for users who may need extra time to review or reach controls, etc. General fixes to ensure TalkBack VoiceOver properly announce UI states such as disabled and unselected on components. Now suppose we want to upgrade from version 0.64 to the latest stable version 0.65.1. Let's look at what changes need to be made. Well, as you can see, React and React Native versions have increased. Also, the Metro and React Test Renderer versions have been increased. And React Native CodeGen version 0.0.7 is now needed as a dev dependency in the package.json. We have these changes in these two files. SDK version increased from 29 to 30. JCenter has been sunsetted and read-only now. We have removed JCenter as a Maven repository and updated dependencies to use Maven Central and Jitpack. And the build tools of Gradle has updated. Upgraded the Philippa 0.93 to support Xcode 12.5. The Android Gradle plugin version has been upgraded, and version 7 is also supported. And target the iOS platform to version 11 in pod file. And also, OKHTTP upgraded from version 3 to version 4.9.1. So there we go, we reviewed the new features of the new version of React Native 0.65. Now, if you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video.